said when I walked through those two doors and saw all of your wonderful faces in that beautiful ocean, we got $1 million view cheap. It was great. I just want to thank everyone who came from a lot of places. My family, best family, came from the East Coast, and Philippe tells me we got somebody here from Korea, Philippines. I saw somebody from Pixley, California, so it really is a global event. Are you guys streaming this, by the way? No? All right. But all of you had to brave this beautiful weather and the high hotel prices, so thanks for being here. Naomi and Rob, thank you for this brand new shiny sunblock. We just love this guy. You know, Philippe, your faith, your love and affection, and your concern and care for Deanna is just amazing. And for other people, you can see them all here. And we couldn't be blessed more. Your sense of adventure. And from what I hear, you don't want to settle down quite yet. But you know, before Deanna told us they wanted to get to meet her special buddy, Beth and I, when Deanna would come home from college, like around Thanksgiving in December, we had our eye on somebody else. And this guy was scoring a lot of touchdowns. You may have heard of him, Tim Tebow. And he would score, and everybody would be cheering, and he'd get down on the knee, and we looked at Deanna over on the slope and said, "He's still single." But today I can say, Tim Tebow is a loser. We got a winner. We got Philippe. So Deanna and Mom and I are so proud of you, your faith, your love and care for Philippe and so many others. And now in your career, working with challenged juveniles, and you've spent time with adults, and you blessed us in so many ways. And there was a heartfelt moment I had this week, and I thought I wanted to share it. Beth put together a scrapbook, and it had 25 years of wonderful memories for it. There was one memory that really touched my heart. And I thought back to, I think it was first grade, we were in the Wizard of Oz. I guess who got to play Dorothy? Deanna. And she got to sing Somewhere Over the Rainbow. The skies are blue and dreams come true. And I knew when you were going to sing that song that day, there were going to be a lot of tears welling up. Because your first 5 or 6 years were challenging. You went through a lot of surgeries. And some of those were experimental. I thought your mom and you spent more time in that hospital than you did at home. But a lot of people in this room, it was great love, support, prayer, and we were blessed, and you've run marathons with some of the folks here. So I just want to thank everybody who is here, who's been here today, for another wonderful big rainbow. To Philippe and Deanna, the new Lazaros, we chose to. To something.
What it is to love others, to be patient, the way he's been so graceful with me, and all the times I complain and yell at him for getting into stupid situations. And but he's always been there for me. He's always been a loyal friend. And even when I had like a midlife crisis. Christ and decided to go on a spontaneous road trip to San Francisco, which once again, I don't do that. And so Philippe was ready to just drop everything and go with me, and he's just been such a good friend to me, and I probably don't tell him this enough, but he's one of my best friends, and as an only child, he's the closest thing to a brother I've ever had. And so I just love him so much, and those characteristics that he's shown me in my friendship, I've seen so much in just his friendship and now relationship with Deanna. And so I know he's going to be such a great husband for her, because Deanna too is also just another super close friend of mine, and she's one of the strongest and wisest women I know. And I know, and I love her because we have a lot more things in common personality-wise than Philippe. And so the way we bumbled a lot over being frustrated with Philippe. But because of that, it's how I know she's going to support him and love him so well and all his whatever ideas comes up with, because Philippe is a...
Hello. Oh, what?
Hello.
Hello?
Just banging on the table.
Man.
Hello. I tried to get some. Hello.
Oh, there we go.
There we go. Whoa, that's kind of weird.
Modern technology. And
this is my first time practicing in front of someone other than Simon. So, I am Shelly. I am Deanna's sister. So I've known her for a pretty long time. And the interesting thing about Deanna was she kind of had a head start on the whole like romantic thing. She had her first kiss in kindergarten, and Matthew Darnell promptly pulled on her, so she got in trouble from that first kiss. But so she's always been this romantic person, very into that kind of a thing. So we're all shocked in college when all of a sudden it became the subject that shall not be talked about. And of course it was awkward because all of us wanted to know. And but Deanna decided she was very firm. She was going to create her own legacy. Her own legacy that did not depend on anybody else or dating or anything like that. But the rest of us all wanted to talk about it. So at every family get together, did Deanna tell you anything?
No.
Well, did you ask? God, no, of course I did not. And this went on for about 2 years while Deanna was making her single legacy. But as you may know, Deanna and any legacy, particularly Subaru legacies, do not last longer than a year, maybe 2 years. So then one day she called me and she said, I have this date with this boy named Philippe. And I tried to play it cool. Because, oh my God, she's bringing up the subject that shall not be talked about. And I don't want to seem too into it. I don't want to push my luck here. But she told me about it, and she was very excited. And she said, oh no, this is different. So what does that mean? well, anyways, I've always kind of been overprotective of you, I think is fair to say. So I was still like, I don't know about this. But the next time we went to Santa Barbara, he met us at the pier, and he was actually early. I didn't know this, but this was a huge deal for him to be early. I can appreciate that fact now. And then he suggested that we go to a French festival, and he got duck confit, and I was like, okay, I can hang with this guy. He's pretty cool. Deanna was right. There was something different. And Deanna and Philippe have a very interesting relationship. They balance each other out very well. If you see Deanna singing, and you know there's some videos of this, singing or dancing, Deanna and then Philippe just hops right in there. And they're going to serenade you and give you a duet whether you want it or not. And then Philippe, he comes up with these insane travel itineraries that no sane person would go on. And Deanna's like, sure, I'm gonna book a flight too. So they just balance each other out and are always willing to dive in together with things. So I just think that's pretty cool. And so is Simon. But anyways, I did want to give you a little marital advice because You will get plenty of it. I don't know. I've looked over my wedding videos. Everyone has the same advice, and a lot of it's wrong. The main one that people say that's like way off is never go to bed angry. I don't know about everyone else, but I know Deanna and I know me. When I'm tired, I get cranky. So sometimes you need to go to bed. Sometimes it's not that big of a deal, and a little rest just makes all the difference. The next thing, and it's not as wrong, they'll say, oh, Deanna's always right. The wife is always right. And that's just not true. I really wish it was. And I find out more and more often it's just not. And the thing that people say that is actually right is always put the other person first. And this is an idea that is very clearly articulated in the Bible. And actually, the pastor, I don't know if he's here, but he talked about that in his speech, where they say, you know, the woman is supposed to be submissive to her husband, and the husband is supposed to love his wife the way Jesus loved the church. And I think we kind of, as a society, hang on to that word submissive and say, oh, I don't like that. But really, when you think about it, what Jesus did for the church, he laid down his life. Like, that's way scary. That is putting yourself before the other person. And of course, it has to go both ways or it just doesn't work. So that's pretty much my mushy, well, no, I have more mushy stuff. So to a happy beginning of the greatest adventure yet, to Philippe and Deanna, I am so excited for you to be my brother and an uncle to my children. And two people I know who actually haven't been married for very long summed up marriage just beautifully. And this is what they said. In sickness, in health, no matter your wealth, close or far, wherever you are, in good times, in bad, happy or sad, with God as our witness, let's do this business.
The second best man. Okay, Daniel.
Cool.
Co-best man. I'm sorry. It's just a habit. A little battle Daniel and I have, but...
Thank you, Mom.
Anyways, I only go back about three years with Philippe. And so we started living in a house together. We did not know each other at all. And so the first way we interacted was... hot tubbing, actually, as weird as that sounds. And so, we kind of had, I wouldn't call them mandates, because they weren't really mandates. We didn't really, like, take each other out, but or have, like, deep, intimate, romantic conversations or anything like that. But we connected. We bonded. And so these hot tub conversations and times, we made it a weekly thing. And it was, I think through this, like, I was really shown that I could be a friend, like, me personally. But also that Philippe was valuable as well. And so he taught me that friendship was valuable, and it was something to invest in, which I think is really important because Philippe, if you guys haven't known Philippe, he has a blog and a book, but I think overall, if you just get to know Philippe, you'll know that he's about connecting and being present in the moment with you, and showing you love through that. He listens well, he responds well too. And he responds with patience, and he responds with love and kindness. And I think Dee knows that quite well. And Dee has to have patience with him at the same time. But through their relationship, I think I've been able to see and grow in my own relationships with other people. And my relationship with Dee, as a friend, she's taught me a lot of what it means to have relationships with other women. And just what it means to respect women. And so just because she's a very strong and caring and honest person, one of the first memories I have with Dee is we went to this place in Isla Vista called Bagel Cafe, and we had a bagel, and she was just very honest with me about who I was, and she was able to answer my questions in not an awkward way. And so she really knows how to deflect awkwardness, and so I think that's why she's perfect for Philippe. Because I think everybody knows Philippe as this kind of quirky, awkward kind of. I listen to Super John Stevens and Vampire Weekend all the time, but And I do make weird videos of me dancing all the time. But I think beyond that, she knows how to respond to those and embrace those very well. And she joins in with him and loves him for that. And so I think that's the sacrifice and the joy that I see in that, in their relationship. And I learned from that. And I learned what it means to give and what it means to give to receive. Because both of them are very good receivers in their own ways. They know how to ask for things, and they know how to say and to communicate sacrifice to one another. One of the strongest things that I've seen come out of their relationship is they know how to, they don't compromise, but they sacrifice for one another. They're 100% in their relationship. I'm not too emotional right now, and so I don't really have anything too touching to say, but the memory that I have, when I was living with Philippe, he came home one day, and he asked, there was three or four of us on the couch, and I may not even remember if I was there because I've heard it secondhand so many times, but he asked me, he's like, guys, what is like the top three things that you would never think would happen? And we're all like, the Martians came, or Sammy Sosa hit another home run, or I don't remember the things that we came up with. But in the end, it was, he told us that he was going out on a date with Deanna. And as you guys know, like through the slideshow, like we were able to see like the relationship progress. But we knew it was coming, and we knew it was good, and we knew it was something that like God had planned, and that was fitting. Like we just saw how they connected.
Sorry, this is like a fourth speech, but they wanted to do friends next to them, I guess. So anyway. Hi, my name's Caitlin. I met Deanna and Philippe in college, and I can honestly say I don't remember how we met, but I think that's good. I think that means our friendship is natural and organic and kind of happened. I do remember that Deanna and I went on a coffee date to talk about Seattle, and I left that coffee date, and I didn't know at the time, but I left with my best friend, and from that coffee date, our friendship grew super fast and super real, and I did not expect it at all. And she ended up moving in a house with us with 10 people. And yeah, right. And every night she would come in my room and jump on my bed and make this noise. I can't believe I'm gonna do this. She made this noise every single night. And would just like come on my bed and we would have these long conversations to talk about life. And she doesn't know that. She knows now, but at the time I like was really struggling to find real people like in San Barbara when you're 20 and everything's dramatic, whatever. And so anyway, so then when I met Deanna, it was like, I hate to be like cliche, but really like your soulmate, like your friend. And our friendship is really easy and organic and natural and wonderful, blah. Anyway, so currently, so Philippe went to Argentina. That's how Philippe says it, I'm sorry. So he was like, I didn't sign a lease, I need to bum around for 6 months, can I bum at your place? We're like, sure. So he ended up staying in our place for a while, and so we would all talk and stuff. And one night, I came downstairs at like 2 in the morning to grab water, and him and Deanna were sitting at our kitchen table, just having this like really long, intense conversation. And I remember going like, that's interesting, what's going on there? But I didn't say that. And I went upstairs, and then slowly, I kind of always thought something, but I never said anything, because, you know, whatever. And then Deanna, like one day, was like, Philippe, and we could like would talk about it all the time, and Philippe never got it, and it drove me crazy. Like for months, Philippe, she liked you, like months, and like I wanted to hit you so many times. Like I love you, like I love you so much, you know that. But like in college, and like when Deanna and I would have our little gossip sessions, and she would just be like, I don't understand, like what's going on, and I'd be like, I don't know, do you want me to hit him? Like, put on a little mask, he'll never know. So then when he finally did ask her out, and yeah, with the San Diego half marathon, or I ran a half marathon, she ran a marathon, that was coming up, and then I got like a text message like, Philippe wants to hang out, like blah, blah, blah. And then when he finally asked her out, she called me and she made her same noise, like super excited, like so she was screaming in the phone and I was at work and it was like, so exciting. So yeah, and when they went out, it finally, to me again, was just like it was natural, and it just made so much sense to me. And from being their friend first and seeing their relationship grow out of their friendship, it's amazing. And I know we've all talked about like sacrificial love and blah, blah, blah. But not even just that, like the way that they just have fun together. And like, I think sometimes we are told in our society and movies, like, oh, love needs to be this really intense thing, and it should, but at the end of the day, like, you need to be each other's best friends. And that's what I see from each other. I see them genuinely enjoy each other's company, and I want to cite like a specific time. We went on a road trip to Montana. If you guys don't know, Montana's pretty far, so we had a lot of time in the car. It was one time, and it was at night, and we, like, me and Matt were in the back seat, and Deanna and Philippe were in the front. Philippe was driving, and they were just listening to songs and singing together and just holding hands. And I know this is weird that I was like watching, but I remember like, but I remember in that moment thinking like, this is love. Like what they have, this is love. And oh God. I'm not gonna keep this together. And I'm just so excited for them. And you know, I've been super blessed to be in both of your guys' lives. And to see from being friends to that night in the kitchen, you guys staying up late, just having a long conversation with you. So, the only thing I can say is continue to be each other's best friends and just continue to celebrate, like Matt kind of said, each other's differences. Never cycle Deanna, that is my biggest word of advice. Never cycle her. She will not be cycled. But yeah, continue to love each other. I'm super excited for the future. Let's have some babies. And super stoked. And I can't wait for you guys to move to Northern California. We'll be all together again. Yay, the end.
That we could make speeches, I was like, yes, I don't have the fear of public speaking. So. I just want to say, we...
Thank you. Can you guys hear me well? It's good. Oh, that head. Okay, I thought I was going to do this stand-up comedy before the dance party started. It's kind of awkward, but you know, I'll do it to bless my good friend, Philippe and Deanna, for their wedding. And so again, my name is Jihan, I'm Philippe's friend from South Korea. Yes, I do speak English. Hey Chris, where are you, Chris?
Chris,
yeah, I do speak English in Chris, yeah, it's good. Alright, and then I do send the comedy in English, and I left in Spanish. Sorry, I don't speak Spanish at all, so no offense if you get offended during my stand-up comedy. Please forgive me. So I'm just kidding, and I'm going to continue kidding for the rest of my life, for the rest of my stand-up comedy. Yeah, so stand-up comedy. So I'm supposed to be kidding, right? Let's hear it. Yeah, so I'm I was supposed to memorize all the jokes, but man, jet lag is real. Yeah, I came to the US, for example, about a week ago. And the microphone is not jet lagged. Okay, so I'm so honored to be one of the groomsmen of my good friend, Flea, who is one of the most passionate, warm-hearted, and intentional people out of all the people who have got to marry in Santa Barbara when it rains. Yes. In the city of all year long, sunny weather. And again, I'm from South Korea, and you might be wondering why I ended up here and how Philippe and I have become friends. Okay, here's the story. No, he was not my English teacher when we first met. We interned together at an international non-profit organization called Liberty in North Korea, or LINK. We worked for North Korean refugees. And then I still, at the time we worked about 3 years ago, and then I still worked there, but the fact that I still worked there, that doesn't mean that there was a reason why he left. So, to clarify. And so, second language, so it was hard to remember how to pronounce his name. So you know, I kept mispronouncing his name as Philippe instead of Philippe. Yeah, so still sorry, Philippe, whenever I read my Bible, I still think of you because I'm one of Jesus' disciples, Philippe. And then I feel like I'm not the only one who has mispronounced his name, right? Because I have seen some Americans. So the real, like the funny part now. To be more specific, my Korean background. So for example, you know, I'm from South Korea and I eat rice every day. And people in South Korea eat rice every day. It's not a stereotype, it's a fact. So cultural lesson, here we go, right? So ever since I came to the US, this time, about a week ago, I've been eating rice almost every day, even tonight. Yeah, one of the dishes that we have was the rice, right? Yes, I can never get away from you guys. Thank you for just being considerate for my culture. I can't believe that was a surprise. And he is so good at recognizing me for eating rice every day and encouraging me to be just who I am by continually eating rice every day. Thank you, Philippe. Like I shared earlier, I worked with Philippe about 3 years ago. At the time, we were just four. So, because we are unpaid interns, right? So we have to do whatever we have to do to survive. And then